everybody.
Thank you.
I'm thankful to the organization to give me this opportunity to meet people whom I normally don't meet.
Of course, two, three are exceptions whom I meet, and I love to meet them, you see, there's no problem. As Vijayashree has said that my whole life I have been associated with transport. First railways, so for urban transport as such is concerned, I think my involvement is almost 30 years now. Unfortunately, even till today, urban transport does not exist anywhere so far as the government of India or state government is concerned. The experts group, which was appointed by the Planning Commission for their 12th five-year plan, of course now Planning Commission has also gone along with them. That commission has used the word saying that the urban transport is an institutional and constitutional orphan. Earlier, the word used was only by the World Bank people, one Mr. Thompson, Lee Thompson. He came to Mumbai. I was chief engineer MTP at that time. And he had three and a half hours of session with me. And during that period, he said that he has gone around the places, but there is no owner of the system. I said, this is not an orphan. It has got too many fathers. So really, you do not know whose child is this. Then he says that you people are managing the system reasonably well. And when we see that ocean of humanity at Churchgate and VT, we have no solution for you. I said, yes, we don't need your solution, we need your dollars. We know the solution, we need money. What has happened that urban transport as a subject was never considered a problem? In the constitution which was written in 1950, transport, yes, railways, yes, but what is this urban transport? Because at that time the concept that cities will grow like this and develop like this, perhaps the constitution writers were not very clear at that stage of time, and we don't blame them. We don't blame them to think so much 50, 60 years ahead. That's why somewhere around 70s, early 70s, the Planning Commission woke up and they said this is an important subject and cities are growing and there is nobody looking after this important subject of mobility. We must do something about it. And the something they could do about it, because at that time railway was the only organization which they could rely upon. So they asked the railways that you set up special organizations in four mega cities, and they were called MTP Railways. MTP stood for Metropolitan Transport Projects. The idea was that this MTP organizations for Madras, now Chennai, Calcutta, Delhi, and Bombay, now Mumbai, they will look at these problems like an independent transport experts and come out with solutions today, tomorrow, what should be done, how should we tackle the problems of this. Now see Mumbai or Calcutta of 70s and today in 2014, but at that stage this organization started working, and in this city they made a lot of study work and they come out with number of suggestions. The three major suggestions which they came forward that time to improve the suburban system. One was that they say we have already got five corridors. Their corridor means one up and say one fast, one slow corridor, or two corridors. Same way, two western, central, and one harbor. So we have five corridors. And they said we should have three more corridors. Sixth corridor, seventh corridor, and eighth corridor. Sixth corridor was a new section altogether, starting from somewhere near Fort and going from the BPT area, from Rowley, going over to the Western Railway, Andheri. The intention was that between Central and Western, there should be an interchange, there should be an interrunning of trains, and there should be facility. And later on, extend this corridor like a Y, go to Thane, make 6 lines instead of 4 lines. The second thing they suggested at that stage was that you have the 7th corridor starting from Colaba, go via areas which are not hitherto served by the railways, and reach Bandra, and then maybe to Kurla. Again, the intention was that I should take the rail services to those areas which are not being served by the suburban system. And this was purely underground corridor right up to Bandra, and from Bandra to Kurla, it was supposed to be an elevated system. And the third system which they suggested that stage was that we should have from Sivri undersea corridor connecting Navi Mumbai that side. There was not even a concept of Navi Mumbai at that time, but they were very clear that that area either today or tomorrow will develop. Like that, they came out with several suggestions to improve the urban transport scenarios in all the major cities, and some of the projects were undertaken also. But the major problem, as usually happens, all this project is from where do I find money to do these works? Indian Railways were very clear because they said we'll do the railway metro work first in Kolkata. And once we learn the experiences from Calcutta, we'll go to the other cities. We don't want to touch underground metro work because we have no experience, plus we have no money. And after they started work in Calcutta and all kinds of difficulties were there, then at one stage, railways in the 80s, they raised their hand and they said, sorry, this is not my baby. We'll complete this project, but hence onward, if you want anything for urban transport, find money somewhere else. Yes, we are willing to work your contractors as your advisors, but not your financiers. This is your baby, urban transport, find money, I'll come and do work for you. At one stage, railway even offered to have an all India setup, like a metro rail corporation or something which will tackle the projects in all the major cities. Perhaps it did not materialize. Had it materialized, perhaps I would have been the first MD of that corporation, yes. Because I was sounded for that, I said, no problem, I will come to Delhi and we'll do that job. And that stage, the government of India said, okay, since railway is unable to do this work, they did a business distribution, allocation of business order. And in that allocation of business, they transferred the urban transport subject to Ministry of Urban Development. Urban Development Ministry didn't know the spelling of what is urban transport, how it is spelled. But somebody had to be in charge of it. Railways are very clever, but I should say they were realistic. They said, since our priority is not suburban, our priority is long distance services, we will provide the know-how, but money you have to provide. So the technical aspect, planning aspect, safety aspects were still kept with the railways. Rest, line ministry was made as the urban development ministry. No problems. After Calcutta, there was no metro work, therefore no issues. Calcutta metro took its own time, sweet time. They started in 70s and finished in 95. 25 years, 144 crores sanctioned estimate, finished at 1744 crores. No problem, because railway has got a big pocket. Slowly, slowly money keeps on coming. Today also they run under heavy subsidy. So railways estimates saying that this is not for them. So they said, okay, metro, this is how you meet this. So far as other suburban services are concerned, we are willing to improve, but we have no money. Existing services, 50-50. New corridors, 2/3, 1/3. It was an excellent model at that time propounded by the then railway minister and the Maharashtra chief minister, when Navi Mumbai project was the first project which was sanctioned on cost-sharing basis. And if today Navi Mumbai has got 2 million people plus living over there and a thriving city and with property prices going from 0 to 100, the credit should go to that model which was brought in, and then that line could be completed, and then to Panvel, and then to Thane. Slowly, slowly that model was expanded and it was done. A good job was done. I was lucky to be associated with number of these projects in my service career related to urban development in Mumbai, in Calcutta. That stage, I will say it was somewhere now in 89-90. At that stage, the Maharashtra government, they wanted to go for BUTP2, Bombay Urban Transport Project. Phase one was already done. In phase one, Maharashtra government purchased basically the buses. It was basically road-based system, and they got money from the World Bank, invested in buses, maintenance, that kind of job. They went to World Bank for the second installment. We want the next phase. And World Bank look at their proposal. They say, you want to tackle urban transport problem. Where is the railway in this? We are not going to look at your plan, your proposal, unless you involve the railways. So therefore, railway was brought in at the instance of somebody else, not by choice. Perhaps they don't want to have brotherhood with railways and all that. I don't know the reason. But World Bank virtually forced us to come together. At that stage, how do we start dialogue with the World Bank? What should be the likely projects? Forget about who will finance it. At that question was, what kind of projects we need in suburbans and extensions and all that? So a committee was formed of 8 officers, 4 state government officers, 2 from the Central Railway, 2 from the Western Railway. And I, as Chief Engineer MTP, was the secretary of that committee. And the first report which we prepared, number of suggestions we included in that report, and that became the basis of discussion with the World Bank. That there should be some document on which the discussion should start, like a draft. And then you can refine and improve upon that draft. The World Bank, after a lot of discussions, they said, okay, we will finance rail component, road component, and whatever else proposals you have got. But this work will be done by a separate organization. They didn't want the state government to do it. They didn't want the railways to do this project. They said this needs a dedicated time, attention, and a separate organization you create. That is how MRVC was born. And today, without being, because nobody is now asking me that question, I virtually lost my job at that stage. Our chairman, railway board, and member engineering was so annoyed at us that how dare you people suggest these things, that these projects are required for Bombay. Thanks to our general major at that time, he said, they have done it at my instance. So he stood by us, therefore no danger to us. I could retire peacefully. Well, MRVC was created, and they said that since it basically that BUTP2 became MUTP1, because there was no Bombay now, so Mumbai became the project. And MRVC was created an organization, a joint venture of the railways and the state government, with 51% railways share, 49% by the state government. Obviously, railway was given bigger share because major projects were on the MUTP, were of the railways only. And MRVC came into existence somewhere in 97, 99. That was the time I left the city. I went to Calcutta as Calcutta Metro in charge there. Again, there was a chance that I should come back to Bombay, because somehow state government thought that he is our old friend. He writes reports in our favor, so get him back over here. But I was busy there, so the railway decided to post somebody else. But let me tell you that MRVC, from that time, really they became functional somewhere 2-3 years later, by the time things were done. And by now, MRVC has done, I think, they have brought in number more than 100 new rakes, they have created new corridors, they have been listening. Because if you want to avoid the crowding, which is the biggest curse of the railway system here, I think using overcrowding is a very mild word. It should have been overflowing trains, you see. I made one presentation in one of the seminars in Hong Kong about Mumbai suburban systems and all that. And somebody asked me, how do people get in? Because those photographs which were shown to them, they cannot imagine that kind of crowd. I said, you have not to worry. You have to simply stand at the right spot. The crowd will see to it that you are in, and then coming out also, they will push you out. Only make sure you are not on the wrong side of the train. So that's genius. So says that the condition is obvious. In last 3 decades, railway has added the capacity to about 2.5 to 3 times number of services and carrying capacity. Whereas the traffic demand, the traffic requirement has become almost 6 times. It means every train must be carrying twice the number. So if inside space is of 2,000 people, 2,000 people find place either inside or outside. So when you say that 4,500 people are traveling or 4,000 people are traveling, well, the numbers indicate that if they are not traveling, then how 7.5 million people are traveling? Because by the actual capacity and the number of trains which are running, that 7.5 million number cannot be achieved. It can be achieved only by roof travelers and by the window travelers. Reason is that we have been asking for more and more capacity, more and more capacity, but capacity needs money. Capacity is not generated just like that. You require new trains, you require extra power conversion, you require stabling facilities, you require maintenance facilities, you require staff to run those services. And all that money is needed. And I must say that World Bank so far has been generous enough to provide first for MUTP-1. Now MUTP-2, they are not giving money for the full project, but they are only financing the rolling stock part of it, which is perhaps the major component. Just now, the more and more capacity, okay, but there is a limitation, there is a saturation point beyond which the railway or the existing lines will just not be able to take more load, more traffic. Why are we converting from 1500 volts DC to 25 kV AC? Because otherwise there will be a substation every station. Then there is no place to construct those substations. So you have converted, you need more power for running more trains. You have to change the entire signaling system, because if you want to run trains at 3 minute frequency or 2.5 minute frequency, the entire signaling system has to change. You bring hundreds of new rakes to come into there which will run, where they will stand. Your place requires a stabling place. Off peak, peak hours, they have to be stabled somewhere. Somebody must maintain those rakes. People are required to run the show. Driver required, motorman required, guard required. All this means a lot of money, but a stage comes when so much and nothing further. Therefore, when metro was conceived, one idea was that adding more and more and more capacity on the same corridor does not make sense. Stations are overcrowded. Stations have not been designed for that kind of load. Access to station is not available. Places are overcrowded, encroached. So said we should think of a new setup, new corridors. And that is how Mumbai Metro project was conceived. So that we should have capacity, but capacity on different corridors. We have 2 north-south corridors, and this is the main travel corridor even today. So we must have more north-south corridors so spaced so that I add the capacity on the same corridor, but I do not overcrowd the same corridor. I have new corridors. With one advantage you immediately get, that accessibility will improve. If there are more stations nearby to you, you should be able to reach the station by walk. You don't require second mode of transport. And what we say as a network density, the moment network density improves, the accessibility and things improve a lot. Otherwise, there is hardly anybody in this city who does not have to take minimum 2 modes of transport to travel today. It may be a little out of context. I am staying in Thane and my daughter was working in Malad. So she will first, my driver will drop her from house to station by car. Then she will travel from Thane to Dadar. Then from Bombay, Dadar Central, she will shift to Bombay Western. Then Western, she will take a Dadar train and go to Malad. And from Malad, she will take an auto and go to office. This kind of journeys, which perhaps each one of you is undergoing the same torture every day. So having more and more corridors, that is why we in MMRDA, and when I was there at that time, we were dead against having more capacity on the same corridor. We said, disperse. Let this city have better coverage, better accessibility, so that people do not ask for a second mode of transport. That itself will be the problem. With this concept, the metro project was conceived, and we roped in DMRC, because DMRC was the hero at that time, and they continue to be heroes. Calcutta experience was so bad, nobody wanted to touch the metro with a long pole also. But DMRC experience was so good that every state wants to have a metro. It became a matter of prestige. Oh, there is no metro in my town, my state. I must have it. DMRC, along with IIT Bombay and Tata Consulting Services, they did pretty good job with the assistance of MMRDA's Express Rice and some other outside consultants. They produced a metro master plan with 9 corridors, north, south, east, west, because one biggest problem about the Bombay suburban services is there is no east-west connectivity. So people who, maybe the planners at that time thought that the white-collar people will never meet the black, blue-collar workers. Eastern sector was considered blue-collar, western was considered the white-collar, but today is the other way around. There are more people traveling from east-west than traveling now. They thought that it's not there, but railway came out with, as I told you in the first plan of the 70s, where they went for east-west corridor, but nothing happened. You know what was the cost of that Kolaba-Kurla estimate cost? 425 crores. 20 kilometers. Whole corridor. Oh, today don't talk about it. 74, 75. So in this background now, this what happened now, this project, this was approved, this master plan. Now the question of implementation, the DMRC recommended that this project should be undertaken in 3 phases because everything is not required at one time. Even if it is required, it cannot be done at the same time. You have to think of the city moving. You have to think of the money available, resources, all kinds of things. And now first phase was 3 lines were defined in first phase. Warsowa, Katkopar. Other was Charkop, Kolaba. And third was Mankhurd, Bandra. Bandra, Mankhurd, that 3 lines. And same, again, state government said that since we don't have money and central government is not going to give us any money because central government says, well, railway has already said, we'll not give him money. We don't have money for you. So you want to go for metro, go yourself. So then they decided to go for PPP, public-private participation. Well, we had a hell of a time because we knew nothing about what is PPP at that stage. Road, there was PPP, was very popular at that stage. But in metros, we had no precedent to quote, no reference, no documentation, nothing. But I must say that we did a fairly good job at that stage because the concession agreement, which was finally finalized, the banks were willing to lend money. And if it is a bankable project, it's a good project and it's a good documentation. Later on, the Planning Commission started finding a lot of faults in our document. You didn't do this, you didn't do that. We gave only one reply. Banks have agreed to lend money, therefore it is okay. You don't worry. That is how it started, and of course, if you talk about line one, it will be required another day. And I have already exceeded my targets of 20 minutes. Today it is operational. I have not traveled by that, though it is my baby, I should say, you see. But I understand that 2.5 lakh people who are traveling every day, they are happy with the service, the quality of service, because if you compare the quality of service of metro with the suburban, well, there is no comparison. It's a different thing than now they want to have 40 rupees charges for that. The different stories altogether. The moment Line 2 concession agreement was signed, we started for Line 2. What was Line 2? Line 2 was Colaba, Charco, North-South Line. We went to the central government that this is partly underground and partly elevated section, and we will not be able to prove it commercially viable within the guidelines given by you. Because central government guidelines say not more than 20% viability gap will be given. So our arithmetic was very clear that with more than 10 kilometers, 12 kilometers underground section, it is impossible to do a viable project within 20%. As usual, the documents sent back saying, no, you must try PPP. Then we again got back, all sat together, we said, if we take away the underground section and we only do the elevated section, then it may be that we can bring it within this 20%. And that is how the configuration was changed at that stage, that instead of Colaba Charkop, it became Bandra Charkop and Markur. So part of Line 2, part of Line 3, elevated portion was put together. After about three and a half years of struggle, I should say, because Planning Commission, they refused to accept our first line documentation. They appointed their own consultants, you know, partly, and mess and bigger mess. At one stage, we simply said that we will not bother about your 20%, we'll do the work ourselves. But patience, because state government does not have that kind of money. We could threat, but we know we are hollow. Well, Line 2 finally, I think after about 3 years or so, we went to Patna, we had the concession selected, signed the concession agreement, went for financial closure. That's the end of it. Because thereafter, the people came in, consultants came in, lot of things happened. Work was supposed to be started in all earnestness, but there were several problems. One major problem was about the people, which is the biggest challenge in a city like Mumbai. Any metro project you want to do, you need a big chunk of land for creating the stabling and maintenance facilities. And in this city, you can get everything else except land. How we got that patch of land for this Line 1, again, it's a long history behind it. It took us really a lot of efforts at from the lowest to the chief minister's level to get hold of that few hectares of land in Versova area. Here, Charco, we picked up the dirtiest possible area so that we can convert it into a nice spot. But our friends in MOEF and CRZ clearance and all that, they thought that this ditch is better than a car shed. We brought the team over here, we showed them, no, this is CRZ area, this is that area. And after so many follow-up, in the interesting thing, after 2 years or 3 years, they gave the sanction with 48 conditions. Believe me, 46 conditions we accepted. But two conditions were such that with that two conditions, no operational shed can be constructed. And we said, you relax these two conditions, let the project go ahead. It did not happen. We had the rest of the corridor, quite a lot of areas were available, there was not a problem. Mr. Das is here. There was a lot of resistance from two areas, JVPD area and linking area, that we should go underground, we should not have elevated section. Two, three proposals were made by them, but partially they were not feasible. It was not possible to have only partial underground sections. Well, for one reason or other, it kept on and on and on. In the end, the concession agreement has been given a decent burial, and concession has been now terminated. The good point is with no liability on either side. That is the win-win point for the state government. Otherwise, it could create a lot of contractual problems. Well, you will be all glad to know, and you have read, I am not giving you any additional news, that now state government has taken decision to have only underground sections. Well, whether it is a good decision or bad decision, this is not the forum to comment on that. They will talk about it. What is the worth of it now? I think we'll enter into unnecessary controversy. But we honor the government's decision. And that is how the third line, which was again partly underground and partly elevated. As we said, that since we had segregated that underground section of South Mumbai, we changed the alignment now slightly, refined the model. Perhaps I was instrumental to some extent in that. So we diverted from Mahim itself and went via BKC and to SEEPS. I said, this is, gives you a better connectivity to South. Now you go to the airport, you no change, you connect SEEPS, you connect university, you connect two business areas. It's slight, it's added about 4.5 kilometers of additional alignment. But I am personally of the view that this is a better alignment than earlier, where reaching the airport, you required minimum 2 changes. Now you don't need any change, you'll go through. Well, this was a very expensive proposition because 23,000, 24,000 crores of rupees, no government can afford, no private PPP project can work on that, it is not possible. Wisely, the decision was taken to follow Delhi Metro's model, that means borrow and equity. And once you have changed the model that I am willing to borrow, then money is no constraint. Future generations will see how do they refund that money which I have borrowed. Aaj khao kal khuda dekha jayega jo parman nahi hai. We are borrowing against this line 56% of the money, which means more than 13,000 crores. And by the time we return, this has to be returned in the yens. There is a foreign exchange variations and all kinds of things for which there is no hedging. But I am happy now that after a few ups and downs, the project is back on track, and general consultants have more or less been appointed. My company is one of the members of the consortium, and maybe my association with this project continues, because in MMRDA or out of MMRDA, I will always consider Mumbai Metro as one of my babies. This is, my attachment is emotional. More than physical, you see, that kind of thing. This has happened now. Line 2 also, which was now earlier elevated, government took the same decision also to convert everything to underground. That project has also been sanctioned. Yes, they have done a wise thing, that Daisar Charkop section has also been added for 2 reasons. Number one, land is likely to be available between Daisar and Itna for the depot. And secondly, that area now has developed quite a lot. When in 2003 that project was made, that area was not adequately developed, therefore it was kept as a separate extension. So that will be now about 40 kilometer section, means something like another 30,000 crores. And the other corridor which has been now taken for metro is, which was a Mulund Ghat Cooper. So Mulund Ghat Cooper has been extended to Wadala, with an interchange with the monorail, and then further extended to Thane along Ghodbandar Road. So that will be, I think, another 30 plus kilometer, maybe another 20,000. So 20 plus 30, 50 plus, so about 75,000 crores rupees projects worth 3 are there to improve the transport scenario of the city. We hope and wish that these projects do not face the kind of problems which are usual, which are kind of difficulty things. Institutional problems, many I think problems have already been sorted out, because when we started the work, since we are the pioneers, so there were all kinds of problems, legal problems, which act will apply, who will be the boss, who will be the administration. 3 years we had the fight. We won the battle, but finally we lost the war. This is what happened. Otherwise, it was declared by the group of ministers that the urban transport subject will be fully handled by the state government. Central government will only provide a modern legislation, rest nothing. But from that, then they appointed a committee to write the law. It was called Guts Act. But the bloody Guts Act had no guts. Guided Urban Transport Systems Act. I was the state government nominee in that committee to draft that act. We drafted the act, we circulated that act all over the places, but finally it had its own death, because railways were too strong to be overcome by ministries like urban development. They said, it is rail, and rail means railway, therefore you cannot do without us. You just forget about your guts, come under my umbrella, my act, metro act, this, so I am the boss. Once that was done, then in 2009, hurriedly they did some amendments so that Calcutta Metro, this called Construction of Metro Act, Operations Act, they were amended by the parliament, some slipshod work. All the kind of various amendments which were needed, which we kept on and on and on telling central government and MOUD that unless you do these amendments, you are going to face problems in extending these acts to other cities, which they simply ignored. They kept on telling, no, 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 what is the need, what is this, this will happen. And one demonstration you are seeing, that this 10 rupees 40 paise fare, it is all the result of that legislation issue. So today the institutional issues are more or less sorted out. Financial problems, we have decided to borrow today and see tomorrow happily. So far as the land problem is concerned, well, there is no solution in this city. We have not come forward for any suggestion so far. Maybe you people have any suggestion. Railways are different because their network goes throughout the country. So they can have shed in Virar, they can have shed 10 kilometers beyond that also. But metro is not extending. Therefore, if I have to take my rake to Virar or some other place, I'll spend a few thousand crores just to take the rakes there, you see. So that is not possible. That is one of the big challenges to find a lay and how we come over it. You believe me, we went to the extent of examining an underground car shed below Mahalakshmi race course. And we prepared almost the plans for it, but they were so expensive, and maintenance and operating that shed would have been so expensive that we simply filed that report as not worth further following it up. That has been a problem. Rest operational issues and all that, I think metro is basically a multidisciplinary system. Railways require various kinds of expertise. And whoever is the operator, whether the operator is government or the operator is private, you need people. The bad news is that the seasoned, experienced people are not available. That is why old people like me have still a market. These three projects put together with 75,000 crores of investment, you can understand what kind of manpower will be needed for the consultants, for the site construction, the supervision, the amount of resources which are necessary, how many persons, how this whole work will go together. That itself is a challenge. Forget about other minor challenges you feel. The very size, the magnitude of the projects is a challenge in itself. But I am hopeful. I am hopeful that now, since MMRC has become an active organization with a new MD, a full-time MD, not a shared MT with the AMC, things will be a little better. And maybe not me or maybe some of us, but at least our children, and they will have better travel facilities. They will have a better city where they can travel comfortably, I wish them well in the future. And I request you, all of you, that this is our city. These are our problems. Be critical, but don't stop it there. Just now morning, I came from meeting in our own company. I told them only one point. When you point a problem, have a solution. If you don't have a solution, then think before you raise an issue or raise a problem. One of my bosses has written, are you a part of the solution or part of the problem? He says, if you are part of the problem, then don't enter my room. If you are part of the solution, come and talk to me. So we are all, I should say, intelligent, sensible, prudent people. We have a lot at stake in this city. We have a lot of stake in the future of this city. We must put our best to see that these projects are successful. Well, having said so, a bad news. The bad news is that next 10 years, there may not be any new metro section here. 7 years the earliest, 10 years at the most. Because other two groups which have been, says government has just said, I agree, it will take them not less than 2 to 3 years if my past experience has any meaning. Before we can even think of calling first tender. And the work which we are starting, 2020 is the schedule as per the agreed version with JICA. But out of that, some 1 year and 3 months or 1 year, 6 months have already gone. So we can add something more. But assuming that 2020, also that is about 6 to 7 years ahead. And other two corridors, I do not expect that less than 10 years. Because 2 to 3 years will be the, I should say, the processing time when you take off. And 6 to 7 years execution. So having said that, we have got 75,000 crore projects. It is a long duration projection. But men live on hopes, and we also live on hopes. There's no question of being disappointed about it or being defeatist about it. I congratulate each one of you because you are keen. You want to make this city a mobile city, keep the city running, keep the city moving. As you, somebody who's a sustainable mobility, well, I want to be apologized. I have not understood the meaning of sustainability so far. What does it really mean? I have tried to read a lot, train myself. Every document I open, it gives me some different versions. So I have got some 20, 30 versions in my mind what sustainability really means. Here, London sustainability is some different. Paris may be different, New York may be different, Bombay may be different. So as many cities, that many definitions of sustainability may be there. But one fact is clear, we want to travel nicely, happily, comfortably, conveniently, that is understood. And we wish that that happens sooner than later. Thank you so much for, I have exceeded far, far my time, but the more I speak, the less time you get. And I am here now in front of you. Any questions? This is purely an informal atmosphere. I am not representing any organization. I am not MMRDA. I was in MMRDA. I am not critical of any organization. I am not this thing. Whatever my background, all this 50 years of my career behind me is there, which within about 45 minutes, I have tried to give you a sort of a wide perspective of through things which we have passed. Because each one of the topics which I have mentioned requires a minimum a day to discuss. So we don't have that much of time. I am here in front of you. Any information, any clarifications, any this thing which I can, I am there in front of you. Thank you.
Or is it the 9 lines that was planned?
And 9 lines which were planned, at that time I am talking about, because estimates were in 2003,
out of 146 kilometers, it was only 32 kilometers underground. Rest was all elevated. At that time, the estimated cost was 90,000 crores of the entire 146 kilometers. And the reasons were simply the arithmetic was very simple.
32 kilometers into 264 and balance 100 crore and therefore 19,000 crore, something like that. But the, firstly the time factor, because between 2003, 10 years have gone, and so many other factors have come in, you see, now fully underground sections, and today with all added cost together with the interest payments and ICDCs and JICA payments and all that, this 33-kilometer first section is around 23,000 crores, 23,100 something. So you can put around 700 crores as the cost. Without escalating, if that number I have made it to 740, if you use 40 kilometers of Bandra, this Mankur section, it goes to 30,000 crores. And if you take Thane, Ghatkopar and itna, another 30 kilometers, another 20,000 crores. So this is the rough idea of three corridors.
And what is the total kilometers
that has been planned now? These three corridors will give you 33 plus 40, 73, about 103 kilometers.
And in comparison with the original 146, what would that be?
103 plus 10 means 113, 114 kilometers. What has been not taken up in this setup is Andheri Daisar, that portion tunnel has been kept as it is. Ghatkopar Hutatma Chowk, that has not been considered at the moment because that was planned like a much in the future, saying that if that MTHL develops and you from that area, you have a new entry to the Navi Mumbai side and metro tracks. At the same time, there was a corridor called Siddhi Vinayak Sivri, which we had later on proposed to extend to Navi Mumbai along MTHL. So that underground section has gone, and this is not part of this. So you see that Sivri is gone. This is gone means it is not included in this project.
In this project, but overall it is…
Overall master plan is remains as it is. There is nobody has said it is not there. And slight changes have been done. As I say, extending to Thane was not part of this 146. Rest is a part of 146 only. Only Mulund to Ditna maybe about 10 kilometers. Which, so out of this, you should take out 103, that 10 kilometers means about 90 plus existing, so 93. So out of 146, you can say about 75% of the section gets covered by this. Yeah, that is. Which is not bad. Which is not bad. Because I am personally not in favor of Ghatkopar Hutatma Chowk. Just to, is it still being recorded?
Forecasting, whether we are done or simply as most projects do exponential working, or whether there could be some possible changes anticipated in the location of people where they live, density, population density, the jobs, etc. That means, is there any work done in terms of demand for the travel pattern?
When the metro master plan was proposed, along with IIT and TCS, the entire demand study was done at that stage.
That was 2002, no?
2031.
That was in 2002, not updated afterwards.
No, 2004 master plan has been finalized, but based on the
data of 2002. And that was on the basis up to 2031. That was the projection at that stage. And based on the projections for 2031, all these lines were proposed.
Yeah.
Later on, MMRDA asked for the comprehensive transport study for the Mumbai metropolitan region.
Yeah.
So Mumbai metropolitan region was, I think 2007 or so,
yeah,
late they started.
Yeah.
And their projections were for the region quite a lot. And they assumed that these nine corridors as existing, And still they recommended, I think, 305 kilometers of additional metro corridors in MMR. That means adding to total 450 crores, 450 kilometers, and 200 and odd kilometers of new suburban lines based on their projections of the population, job growth, and the projected traffic. They asked for about 5 or 6 new growth centers, projected new lines, new metro lines, new suburban lines to serve them also. So basis is there. Now, how far that basis is right or wrong, I am not a project, that means.
No, there's just only one small point in this correction, that it was, I have also seen this comprehensive traffic study and all that. They have been assuming the growth rate of 3% per year, 2.5 to 3% per year, which was applicable till 2001. Yeah. From 2001 to now, it has become zero. And there is no likelihood that it may go up higher, at least in greater Mumbai part. And that's why I thought it was quite wise of you to drop the Ghatkopar Andheri, because island population is actually decreasing.
Decrease.
So that I felt sometimes when it doesn't update things, that the macroeconomic factors also change. And
I fully agree with Dathar sir. I as an individual wonder why we are bringing more and more capacity to
South
freeway to South Mumbai. This to it now. Now somebody says elevated corridor, 6-lane corridor, all those people will come, and where they will come, where they will park, they will get into the sea, or what will they do? Why are you bringing all of them over here?
Yeah.
Two islands.
Yes, you are creating two islands.
Yeah.
So there, I am not very clear that why are we doing that. Of course, the railway has got a good, good thing of off the record. Ladies, when they go to buy sarees or clothes, the shopkeeper, he will show them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. They are not happy. He picks up the first one and says, "Madam, ye latest hai, abhi aaya hai." To tab to ko bhool gayi hai ki 9-10 dekha hai. Railway ke jo hamare mantri naye aate hain, hum unke saath yehi formula lagate hain. Unko busy rakhne ke liye railway ki pocket mein bahut ideas hain. When Mamata Banerjee came as the railway minister, he was told that property development mein gold mine hai. And she went all over the earth to announcing railway will make money of property, 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 property. I was in Calcutta Metro, the rights people were appointed, rights was appointed as the in charge for developing property and all that. One gentleman was specifically posted as general manager in charge for that work. He came to see me, Mr. Kher. He gave me a good presentation and good lecture, and I was impressed. After that, I told him only one thing, here, one request. When you complete the first project of property development, please give me a ring. He said, "Sir, why do you say so?" I say, "I would like to congratulate you personally." That phone has still not come. Because this idea of property development, railway has talked about. When did I go to my first training in UK in 83? Before that, also we have been talking. I agree that we are sitting on gold mine. But somebody must know how to dig the gold. You are not able to do that. New Bombay, I must admire the Chief Minister of Maharashtra at that stage. He has the vision that by giving few hundred crore rupees to the railways, and getting the rail link constructed in Mumbai, the benefit which will they draw out of it is tremendous. How much money did they give to the railway, even if two-third cost was counted? I think some 250 crore, 300 crore. But the kind of cooperation, the kind of understanding, all over the country, I have praised Maharashtra bureaucracy during that period. Today, I don't do that. I used to say, learn from them.
Yeah.
Because as chief engineer, I used to go to the chief secretary, "Sir, paisa chahiye." Bola, "Tum phir a gaya paisa lene ke liye?" This is how you used to say, "Tum phir paisa lene a gaya hai?" Maine sab khatam ho gaya jo paisa aapne diya tha, humne consume kar diya sab. So you should feel very happy that we are going fast. Acha, acha, koi baat nahi. He will ring up, release so much more money and all that. So the wisest thing they did at that stage. You agree? Nahi, toh aaj Navi Mumbai, main jab Navi Mumbai I took over charge was in 89. Aap shaam ko Vashi chale jaye to sadak pe kutta bhi nazar nahi aata tha.
That time RCC
na hai. Kutte bhi bhonkne wala ghabrata tha, saala आगे जवाब देने वाला ही नहीं है उसको. दैट वॉज द कंडीशन ऑफ वाशी स्टेशन. आई थिंक शरद पवार वाज देयर
सर
एंड माधव राव सिंधिया वाज देयर. And you know what was the president? One telegram was issued that Minister of Railways and Minister State Chief Minister have decided that this project will be done on 2/3, 1/3 costing. That's all. On the strength of that 3-line telegram, we completed the whole project. The agreement between state government and railway was signed 7 days before opening of the section. 99% of the contract became useless. That also on my insistence. That after 1 week we are going to open the section, at least now sign the agreement. Then Mr. R.C. Sinha and somehow a small function was arranged and the agreement was signed. I am talking of the initiative of the bureaucracy at that time. Hundreds of crores of rupees, they simply gave it to the railway on the strength of that one telegram.
Sir,
this is the wisest thing they did.
Coming back to metro, you mentioned that metro yard is a big issue, land. So why can't we combine metro yards for line 2, proposed line 2 and line 3 at Dahisar or wherever they are planning for line 2? Why you are planning having metro yard at RA Colony?
Yes.
And you can actually easily connect. No, no, but it's a very sensible thing to connect.
I answer you, Paris. If you require 20 hectares at one place and you require 20 hectares at another place, then when you combine two, you require at least 35 hectares together. In this city, you don't have that chunk of land. We even, as I told you, we attempted underground. And even went to the extent of a double-decker parking facilities and shit. But at least that much land should be available. The design of Versova
depot is one of the finest designs which is within that small constrained area. How the entire layout has been fitted is an engineering marvel, I should say.
But nowhere
land is not land. Only solution is that we may, it's my version, that we may segregate the stabling facility from the maintenance facility. That may be possible, that I for long term, especially the long term maintenance, I mean maintenance of POH after 6 years, a maintenance which is required yearly maintenance after 12 months, I may take somewhere else and then I'll have to carry these coaches on trailers. Now from the harbor, how do they come? They come on trailer, crane lifts them and puts them on the ship. So same way I may have to create a facility where I take everything there. But stabling facilities,
but I think they got
right, where do the coaches go? During peak, off-peak hours, where do the trains go? You do require land.
They got 40 hectares, I believe, at Dahisar for line 2, which will come up maybe after so many years.
Calcutta Metro acquired 60 hectares of land, since you mentioned 40, because they had 100 kilometers of metro planned. They were wise enough to go for one lot and acquired 60 hectares. And located in such a way that they can have a combined depot. Finally, it happened that Calcutta had only 16 kilometer of metro. So remaining were only trees we planted there. Now, of course, they have 16 plus 6, 22. But when the east-west line has come, that depot is of no use, cannot be used because there is no connectivity to it.
But here you'll be not creating dead and at SIFs. You know, you have Colaba, Bandra, airport, SIFs, then you go to Film City Road, Bangur Nagar, and go up to Dahisar. So you are actually combining line 2 and 3.
At the moment, that is not the thinking. At the moment, thinking was that we had merged Colaba corridor with the BKC Kanjurmar corridor. So after SIFs, it was supposed to turn east and go and end at Kanjurmar. Now there may be a different thinking that why we have stopped at SIFs, because again, underground portion finished, then that portion was supposed to be elevated. Then between SIFs and Khanda, what is that colony?
MIDC.
No. That कौन सा वाला है वो लोखंडवाला दैट लोखंडवाला वाज सपोज टू बी somebody came out with idea लोखंडवाला कंजूरमार्ग विल बी ए मोनोरेल देन somebody said no from here to there so therefore when all these ideas are fluid it is better to keep them fluid till they become ice so I understand you your idea somebody has sent also that we extend from Seeps and go to Dahisar site but even Dahisar that kind of is not there secondly you cannot have 50 kilometers away a depot then you will have to create so many underground storage stabling facilities
it's a continuous line it's not just a depot
no it's not a question is if I have depot 50 kilometers away from the first station how do I feed the services even now we have created even those Seeps is there Bandra is one of the intermediate terminals where there will be overnight and at Colaba we'll have to create underground stabling facilities where platforms are there and four more additional lines have been created so that overnight trains can be kept there and morning services can be introduced preferably the shed should be on two ends if it is not possible two ends it should be in the middle All right, I'll answer your question. Colaba reclamation was not today's idea. If you look at your DP of the city, that land is still shown as car-shaped. This idea was given way back by MTP that when we have this Colaba-Kurla line, we'll use this as a depot land. And we have given proposal for this land to be used. He said all this muck which will come out of this millions of cubic meter of this muck from these tunnels will use there for and give us this land. He even gave a proposal that we will have a bloody entire thing elevated, leave the water below. No. Then we went for ask adjacent plots are there where best and others are there, give me that land. That has not been given. You say you give me part of the land there at Mahalakshmi, is not given. Give me part land in BKC, nahin. University, you give me. Five alternatives were examined before we ended up at RA because that seemed to, at that stage, seemed to be the least resistant area.
No, but now that will become the most resistant area. So, keeping that in mind…
Finally, that is why when she asked me challenges, I say, here is only one challenge. Let every depot not become the dead end for the project.
Can Colaba still be done? What is the objective?
I have no problem.
You have no problem.
No problem. It will save me a lot of headache. Underground, we have to create. Underground, we have to create stabling facilities and all that. That will be avoided. 74, that site was proposed for Colaba. Delhi Metro's report for Colaba Bandra corridor it still shows that as the car shed. सब वो चारकोव का गंदा साला और गंदा नाला तो हमको उसने किसी ने सीएलजेड क्लियरेंस नहीं तो यहाँ कौन देगा सीएलजेड क्लियरेंस देने के लिए तो अगर वो क्लियरेंस मिलता है आई विल बी द हैप्पीएस्ट पर्सन टू सी दैट शेड गोज ओवर देयर यस प्लीज
यस सर आई एम लीना प्रभु आई एम द चेयरपर्सन ऑफ Forum for Improving Quality of Life in Mumbai Suburbs.
I met you, you gave me your card also, madam.
Well, we started this NGO because we realized that the suburbs are being neglected and it's heartening to know that you all are now focusing on the suburbs in bits and pieces, but still you are. My question is, also the second good news you have given is that there is an alternative in Colaba for this shed because it was a main major concern for Mumbai itself if you're going to cut down trees so we'll surely explore that and whatever pressure needs to be exerted we will do that secondly we have a concern about raising money for all these projects and you all are going to borrow the money two questions on this where are you going to borrow it from and the second one is why not explore the possibility of you know, stock options or shares. People would happily invest in such infrastructure development because...
Number one, from where we are borrowing money? Obviously, our local banks are not that rich enough. They are not willing to lend out that kind of money. We have to depend on external sources. JICA, this Japanese, they are pretty rich. They have a lot of money. They have financed Delhi, Calcutta, Chennai, three areas. They were all the time very keen to come to Mumbai, only we were keeping them away. But the moment they got an opportunity, they are happy that they will be financing at least our line 3. So far now you can say your line 2 and 4, let me call it, change the numbering now, is concerned. World Bank, I understand, has shown interest. JICA may not be in a position to commit more funds because they are likely to commit funds for MTHL, which is likely to be revived once again. After three premature deaths, fourth time, let's see what happens to it. If they finance MTHL, which will be something like 10,000 crores, and line 3, which is 23,000 crores, then they think that they have got enough commitment for this city. But World Bank is one. They have financed MUTP, MUTP 2. They have shown interest that they may finance at least one of these lines.
But they are charging higher interest rates.
Interest rate is high. Their conditions are actually slightly different. JICA is a little more liberal. It is easy to deal with them. No, there are, I'll clarify, there are two different types of contracts. One is a conditional loan, and one is an untied loan. Conditional loan, you have 0.7% rate of interest, and untied loan is 1.4%. So MMRDA, and we have gone for 1.4 and not for 0.7, so that we are not tied to any particular condition of Japanese companies or anything. But since JICA is financing this, their terms, condition, everything, it says eligible countries, every country. When these bids have come, first was general consultants. Every consortium had one Japanese member. Not under compulsion, but maybe as a strategic reasons, I will use that word. And finally, the consortium, which is LBG, is one of the stakeholders in that company. We have a partner, Japanese company, called Padeco. They were the interim consultants also. At that time, there were three members. Now the fourth member, Aegis, has also joined. But there is no condition that I have to have their know-how. But same JICA has lended money to the railways for their what is called as the dedicated freight corridor. There are two corridors, East Corridor, West Corridor. East Corridor is funded by the World Bank, no conditions. You open tender, whoever wins, wins. For the Western Corridor, which is Bombay, Mumbai, Delhi, Ludhiana Corridor, they agreed to accept that lower rate of interest. So every condition, they have to listen to them. It is now the reverse role. They have shortlisted 11 Japanese companies, and you have to partner with them. But World Bank, yes. I don't think JICA will be in a position to finance these two lines. That is always said 2 to 3 years' time. It requires, by the time the central government, PIB, finally clears the project and cabinet approval is given, we were a little bit smarter, we started three activities together, dealing with the central government, dealing with JICA, and appointing interim consultants, so that three things move together. That saved us some time, but which is very, time is important. It's a different thing that some of the advantage which we had planned has been lost for reasons which have nothing to do with the project. But it is more politics than anything else. It is not a part of any project activity. But minimum that much time, you see the whole process, so many agencies are involved, that by the time I can say, go, start the work, it takes time. JICA Today they have not shown any interest, because it means about another 50,000 crores. So even if we borrow 50% of the money from them, it means 25,000 crores. And 25,000, already some 13,000, they say we have other cities also, we can't give everything to Mumbai.
Connected to that, what is the repayment schedule like?
Repayment is like this, you see, we have first 10 years as moratorium. JICA loan. Banks normally give you 2 years moratorium. JICA 10 years moratorium, during which only interest will be payable, no principal. And next 30 years is the repayback period. So it's a 40 years long duration loan. Maybe our next two generations will be visible by that time. Who will refund
it? How much money would we have paid back? 13,500 crores.
Money is with this point. Interest will be paid
annually
along with this at the rate of 1.4.
Okay.
But everything is returnable in yen, foreign currency. That means any foreign exchange variation is to be borne by us, and there is an agreement between central government and the state government that they will share this burden 50-50. Because they are the 50-50 partners for the company, therefore this is a risk which they will share 50-50. But I am committed to pay in the same currency in which I borrow. But time period is
long,
10 plus during, they have nothing called IDC, no interest during construction business. Even during the construction period, the interest on the money borrowed has to be paid in cash. Then and there. Whereas most of the banks, what they do, they capitalize the IDC. Whatever interest due comes during that construction period, interest during construction is capitalized and it becomes a part of the loan. Then you refund. They will give you 2 years moratorium. No financial institution in India can give me 10 plus 30, 40 years.
So that leads me to the next question, which was following from what Sudhir said. You said that a lot of institutional mechanisms have in a sense been sorted out. But our institutional mechanisms in a sense to finance infrastructure or transport is still very weak in a sense.
No, it is not.
Because, say, if you had a special purpose, I don't know, Konkan Rail, I think, was through bonds, and even in Hong Kong and Singapore, a lot of, so you can raise so much money if you have well-structured bonds from the NRI community or within the stock markets also over here, where this can be done, and even something like fuel cess or congestion pricing. So if you had a well-functioning unified metropolitan transport authority, then that is in a position to raise, unlock enormous amount of value, even real estate, and all of it can be ring-fenced to fund these kind of projects. Say, like for Coast Road, they've been doing fungible FSI, where they have 3,500 crores right now lying.
Yeah, I'll answer your question.
So that kind of a thing.
I'll answer your question. First, you said that at least for policy matter, government is very clear that metros they do not intend to do on PPP. Ministry of Urban Development and issues a policy directive that they will not insist for PPP, they will be agreeable to finance government funding. Central government has also agreed that to the extent of 50-50 equity, they will provide. And loan element between 50% to 60%, loan, rest remains 40%, out of which maybe 20-20 may be equity, but for line 3, equity is around 15% both. Why? There are two or three other reasons why we have got less equity. One is that we are getting some money from MIL. We have roped them in and we said three stations we are going to construct in your area and you are a PPP partner, you are going to get advantage. So they are going to pay for the construction of those three metro stations which are coming in the airport area, which will mean about 750 or 760 crores. Then there is some industrial area, because MIDC and all those heaps areas there. There's another pocket from the government which can give us some 250 crores or so. And the third head, which was very reluctantly agreed by us, was saying, again, come to property. We said that MMRDA is already making money out of property. We are using land as a resource. It's not that we are not, we don't know the model. Only thing we have said is we don't want to club them together. They said nothing doing till you commit 1,000 crore that you will produce from property, we are not going to sanction your project. I was present in that meeting, a threat was given. You say today, 1,000 agreed, then we approve your project. Not agreed, get out. That kind of. Finally, we said yes, we'll give it. Now, from where we'll give is so, MMRD has got plenty of resources there.
So, what about the share market, sir?
Stocks share market, so far, madam, the bond portion has not been considered as a as an alternative. He mentioned about Konkan Railway.
Yes.
That was offered as one of the suggestions. But what has finally happened is the money is not being paid by the Konkan Railway, money is being paid by the railways. Here also, we do not expect that they will have enough surplus to give that kind of money. Konkan Railway, what has happened is, they borrowed money from the market. So the moment those bonds have matured, Konkan Railway does not have funds. Konkan Railway is only managing their operational expenses. Then railway has gotten, the railway has paid. The only difference has happened is that instead of paying in advance railways, now they are paying in installments. But bond market is, yes, that depends on Ministry of Finance. If they agree that yes, they will permit the corporation, Delhi Metro they never permitted, Chennai Metro they never permitted, Bangalore they never permitted. Bangalore Metro property, yes, they have done, but they have opened another source, this Asian Development Bank. They got some money through them, who are much more stringent, but at least in India, none of these infrastructure projects, except for Konkan Railway, has gone for bond.
But sir, that was only one project, and maybe it was not handled properly, or they could y'all could learn from the experience and then explore it again. Because, to my simple mind, it seems
can be done. I will say this is something which maybe the financial experts, what kind of market is there, whether government of India, state government wants to borrow that kind of money, that will be a issue which perhaps more financial expertise may be necessary, you see, for me to comment.
Sir, the key point about all these financing instruments, because what is the generation of surplus by the project? I mean, I don't know whether there any fair box can generate any surplus whatsoever. So then only all the stock markets and all these things, they expect that there will be profit. If there will be loss, then there is no real meaning in any equity-related funding.
Mr. Dattar, you have hit the right point. There is no, and I'm using the word no, metro system running in the world except Hong Kong and Singapore.
Yes, correct. That means we should understand.
Who are making money.
Others are making heavy losses.
But having said so, they are not making money out of your box. The entire model of financing, I know several people in MRT, depot land, you said reclamation, the entire Kowloon station, that area is on reclaimed land. They have got 110-storied building constructed on the same area. In one depot, the reclaimed cost was very high. So the government decided to make 4,000 apartments on top of that shed. Hong Kong. And any line government gives them a land today's value and says, okay, you make the line, value go up. Here what happens, you invest and I gain. That money does not go to the project.
I don't know how much money.
Yes.
So that is where
I want to come back, sir.
Yeah.
In Hong Kong, I mean, we have
to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The meaning of integration, they have understood it well.
Right.
You stand from this particular airport express, come to Koyama. Now you want to go to different hotels. No need, there are only three shuttle services. Three different rooms. You pay the same there at airport, get into the stand, come into the city, and you choose which hotel, which route you want to go, return same back also. Their arithmetic works in a different way, you see them. And it works very well. It works very well, that is why.
So that is where my question comes, like the way you spoke about urban transport. But while speaking about urban transport, we are talking about railways and metros. There are other forms of urban transport also, like there are buses, there are autos, you know, share autos, there are various types of urban transport. So, and also we are talking about, yes, metro is going to take another 10 years. We have waited 8 years for the first time to come, and still on ground we do see all the east-west connections blocked. So, is there any other alternative to improve a road transport based public transport?
I just want to actually feed it to projects. That was also a very unique thing.
This issue was presented to the experts committee, this 12th plan, and they give an assessment that fundamentally I select a mode of transport based on my requirement. If the projections of traffic in that corridor are very high, then only rail-based transport has been considered. Mr. Sudhir Badami has got his own views. I accept his views. But it has been considered that if you are exceeding certain levels, say 18,000, 20,000 or in that areas, then only the rail-based system can satisfy. Those corridors which we have talked about, certainly, they are all certainly much beyond in that area. Present suburban system, maybe in the order of 90,000 PPHT. Nope, you can just cannot dream of it. So all selection, whichever today corridors are there, the alignment is such which is going to give very high demand of traffic. You see that. Our line one has not, it has reached its, they are using, I think around 2.5 to 3 lakhs, where the minimum projection traffic was 5 to 6 lakhs. So even till today, they are even about the 50%
of. What is the capacity of the line that we have planned here? For example, I think every 3 minutes you are running 6 coaches train. I think that is what has been planned for.
No. So far as all future corridors are concerned, 8 minutes, 8 coach train, which can carry up to 3,000 people, and 2 to 2.5 minutes, 2.5 minutes because 2 minutes we have to 24 trains an hour into 3,000, 72,000 the limit, because if a corridor goes beyond that limit, then it is better to have another corridor than to load that particular corridor.
That
line 3 is
in that kind of load, you require scheduled facility also equally large.
The number of rakes which are required, today I may be using 4 coaches, but all lines will be designed for 8 coaches. So that today I will be using the same line for 2 coaches, right? But later on in future I require, though line 1 means they are using only 4 coaches, but the entire depot is designed for 6 coaches. Why did we go for 8 coaches in this section? Because 8 coach train, the amount was not in this section. It was anticipated that 6 train will be more than enough, because 6 gives me about 2200 fully loaded. And 2200, even if they run at 3 minutes of frequency, it gives you over 45,000 minutes. And the system can take up to 2 minutes. Signaling and all that is okay. And by the time that 2 minutes demand really comes, the existing signaling will be obsolete. So in any case, you will be upgrading. And upgradation time, today, to the best of my knowledge, they are running in between 80 and 90 seconds frequency, which is what they do. 90 seconds, comfortable. 2 minutes, fine. Anything, and this is a system has to be, firstly, no manual system will work. You have to have fully automated train operations. And if you want to that, then more money. Yes, you save on the manpower, but you invest in the system. But 2 minutes is, even 2 minutes you will find difficult to operate. 3 minutes, yes, fine. 3 minutes frequency, the manual is okay. Because 3 minutes means 1.5 kilometer. Even if you average 30 kilometers a day, and two stations are about 1 kilometer away. So the minimum distance between two trains will be about 1.5 kilometer, which is good enough. Good enough, you see. So this can run even without signaling.
So considering New York and London have had their metro, underground metro, maybe a century ago. They are also islands, and we are also an island. What problem are we facing? What is the hiccup over here for us to have an underground metro?
What is the problem? No problem? Our problem is slightly different because we have got reclaimed land mostly. The alignment will not only pass through them, but pass through the reclaimed area also, which none of them have that issue. What we have done is that we have tried to go deeper so that we are mostly in rock and not in the reclaimed portion. But some portion of the reclaimed area we cannot avoid, we have to pass through. Going for the, Mr. Das is president at Manabhav meetings initially when the UPD was obtained. I had only one observation. They asked me, what is your personal view? I said, my personal view is, if I have money, I go for underground. But there was a big if. It was a choice between having a metro and not having a metro. Now government of Maharashtra and the state government and our central government and others have changed their financing policy. Earlier they said, no money. So bring in private partner who, and private person once he comes in, he is not running a charity organization. He wants his profit. At the same time, central government says, we will not give you more than 20% PGF. That means if 40% viability gap is given, then that you have to manage. The underground metro's cost being 2.5 to 3 times, it is impossible, and let me use that word, to bring and create a financial model which is profitable. Fair also you want to charge, again the term affordable. Again, as I mentioned, one term earlier, I have not understood the meaning of sustainability. Same term, I have not yet understood what is affordable. And to here a person spends 250 rupees to go and see PK. But he pays 100 odd rupees to travel between Thane to BT 50 times a month. What is affordable? Tell me. And then affordable for whom? All the people who are traveling by suburban, even a small section, I am sure. But what happened? The moment after a few years, 2 rupees fare was raised, oh bloody, you want to cry all over the world. You see, affordability is a term which I also use, accessibility, affordability. All metros start with A's. Availability, affordability, accessibility, all A's. B we never reached. Next one. So the problem is this.
But sir, this affordable issue, I mean in London also people find going by metro is expensive. And that is why in last, if you see 2-3 years, in fact 6 years, they have focused only on bus transport, which has increased almost its ridership over 60%. So they are also in such a, you know, developed kind of a city, metro, travelling by metro is expensive for most of the citizens. So
they are very clear that if you have to travel and you have to have the service, you have to pay for it.
It's absolutely
clear. If you don't want to travel by metro, but well, they have a combined sub ticket. With the same ticket you travel by metro, you travel by London bus. Here, your London bus fare, your bus best fare and railway fare, is there any comparison? Forget about London and this city. The fare which West charges you, and the fare which railway charges, is there any comparison, anywhere near the numbers?
No, but metro will be different volume. See, suburban railway is a second class pass system. It will be no fare at all, as I think also free. So that has to be obviously changed. But the point is that some kind of cost recovery basis, it may be 40%, 50%, I don't think 100%. So the operating cost of buses in their run efficiently is much lower than the metro. It is not the case, sir. No, because you don't invest in infrastructure.
Because cost recovery, obviously, mainly if you have to draw fare structure.
Yeah.
You know, what is the situation of Calcutta Metro today? No. It's not free that way. They are not able to recover even their electric engine.
That's how it's driven today.
Well, electric. And their subsidy is almost about 100 crore rupees anyway. Which private party will go to give them money? They are getting that 100 crore because they are the, I should say, the youngest brother of the Indian Railway Brotherhood. Indian Railway has got 1 lakh crore budget estimate. And here there are a few hundred. That 100 is goes as a drop in the ocean, then nobody notices it. Fare, 6 years Calcutta Metro never revised fares. Not for financial reasons, but for political reasons. They raised the fares after 6 years. What was the raise? 1 rupee on every slab. In one day, traffic went down by 30%. Calcutta is that price sensitive. Luckily, Mumbai is no price sensitive so far this time. You go to a bus stop, person waits one bus, no space, he takes a taxi or auto and goes. For him, time is important. Few rupees here and there are not important. As you travel east, money is less important. Time is less important, everything. In Calcutta, I have seen trams being burnt for 5 paisa. Fares being lost. Here, how will people talk? I will take 427 local. That means their unit of time is minute. 427. I was posted as regional manager at Jabalpur from Bombay. I went there. And my officer said, sir, we'll have a meeting this time. What time? 3-4 minutes, 20 minutes. 3 or 4 minutes, 60 minutes. So, got a shock. Anyway, during my 2.5 years stay, I tried to instill some sort of time discipline. You go to Calcutta, further east. There, the unit of time is not minute, unit of time is day. You go to the bank, Dada. हमारा पासबुक जरा अपडेट कर दें तो कल क्या शो कम टुमारो नहीं आया कम टुडे माय शो है कम टुमारो नो नो कम टुमारो यू गो फर्दर टू गुवाहाटी एरिया वगैरह वर्क फॉर 7 years यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड माय फ्लाइट गुवाहाटी देयर इज नो कंसेप्ट ऑफ टाइम इफ यू टेल देम टू एनीथिंग फास्ट दे थोड़ा जल्दी करिए ना Sir, what is the problem? Lie, lie, means slowly, slowly. Take your time. Why do you want to be under tension? Kya hone ja raha hai? Brahmaputra to behti rahegi. Aapko kahe ki chinta hai? Kyun mujhe pareshan kar rahe hain aur khud pareshan ho rahe hain? So this is how we are, right? This city has its own values. Here,
money has different value. Affordability is a different meaning here. Same, but railways, what happens? They have to use the same yardstick for the country. If they had the choice of having different fare structures for different cities, perhaps they could have done it. But since it's under parliamentary control, we don't have. They went for tariff committee. Legally speaking, the railway fares does not require parliament vote. There is no provision anywhere that it should be subject to parliament vote. But somewhere, politicians have grabbed that opportunity because that is the opportunity which gives them good lift in February, March. So they say that fares. Then they decided we'll have a tariff committee, which is provision in the act. Tariff committee was formed, rather tariff commission, I think. or slowly, slowly, before even the formal order has been issued, the powers of that commission have been so diluted that finally it becomes recommendatory in nature. And you know what is the meaning of recommendations here? Recommendations have not even the value, the piece, worth of paper when you write it. Unless those recommendations are implemented, there's no sense. So affordability, fair money, as he rightly says, money has to come, finally, recovery, cost recovery. Social things depend on something else. Metros, I can say, suburban services, services in railway services in eastern sector, northeastern sector, they are socially desirable, but financially not viable. And so far, railways policy has not been financially desirable. At the same time, railway has to give 7 to 8% dividend every year to the central government. They used to get 80% money from the central government. Now their budgetary share is in the order of 28 to 30%. From where do they get the balance money? So after every discussion, all these things, finally things turned around to cash. Recovery model is such that we are not prepared to. How does MRVC recover? World Bank agreed that every ticket you put 10 rupees or 15 rupees surcharge. And they calculated on 7.5 million people travel. So 7.5 into 10 rupees also gives me so many crores of rupees every month. And they go over a period of time, yes, your model is good. They paid. CIDCO gave us money. That means state government gave us money for New Bombay. There is a surcharge to cross Thane Creek Bridge, go to Navi Bombay. The entire surcharge is passed on the state government. Truly speaking, state government has not invested any money in that. They have only given money temporarily on loan. Later on, railway became wise. They say, if we are giving 1/3 share, I should have 1/3 of this surcharge also. So future contracts are with 1/3, 2/3 on the revenue also. Calcutta Metro, they wanted extension, 8 kilometers. They said, give 2/3 money. West Bengal government, two-third paisa unke liye dena kahan se layenge bichare, big mange hai waise hi. So I was general manager at that time and I was told political reasons, wait, tomorrow budget is there and this project will be sanctioned. You go to the writer's building and get us a letter from the chief minister that they are willing to pay 1/3 if not 2/3. Now you see how we dilute our own considerations. Well, I had no alternative. I rushed to writer's building, went to Saudi Chief Secretary and requested him, you want this project? He said, yes, yes, we are very keen, but you are not willing to pay for it. He said, so much money you want, 900 crore rupees project. From where do I produce 600? I said, will you agree for 300? Yes, that looks okay. I said, this is the opportunity. Get a letter, give me, so that tomorrow the budget will announce your extension of 8 kilometers further. And true to his word, 4 o'clock was the target given to him, 3:30. The letter was delivered to me, duly signed by the chief minister, which I faxed to Delhi. And next morning in the budget speech, extension of that 900 crore was sanctioned. Be done. So considerations when we come to projects, needs, no needs, money, no money, I think considerations are many, which we are not competent enough to agree or disagree. They are the realities which we should face them as they are, and the good or bad, whatever they are. But there is no doubt about it that here, how could Delhi have 200 kilometers of running, and by the time their third phase is over, they will have around 400 kilometers of metro? Preferential treatment?
That's what they do in Delhi. They want to make it super class. So we'll take two more questions now. And Mumbai, they are left.
Madam, ek disadvantage hota hai center or state government ek hone ka. पहले कांग्रेस थी दोनों जगह, बीजेपी है दोनों जगह. अगर यहाँ अपोजिट गवर्नमेंट हो ना और उनका वहां पर पार्लियामेंट में 25-30 मेंबर हो, तो फिर देखिए कैसे फटाफट सेंक्शन आती.
ये काट देना यार, ये उसमें रिकॉर्ड नहीं करना कल को मेरे पीछे आ जाएगा पकड़ने
सर. There is this thing related to MTHL, as you said that it is being revived with JICA's funding. Initially when MSRDC and MMRD, they were competing for MTHL project, MMRD said hum metro bhi include karenge usme. But now when it goes on paper, like tendering process or financial reasons, metro has been kept aside. And as you said, there has to be a greenfield project which is preferred in terms of even metro. So in order to sweeten the deal for private players for toll collections and concession period, metro was kept aside. What is your view? Shouldn't metro be there on MTHL? That's the first thing.
I'm not preparing the DPR, that's what I know.
Very important question.
We prepared the report because your Varli Suri, that Siddhivinayaka area, the same corridor we wanted to extend to Navi Mumbai across MTHL from Suri. And the idea was that you have an interchange with the Kolaba, that corridor also. You have interchange with the Tatma Chowk with this also, like that, so that this can feed that area and you can open up that area also further. DPR, we are prepared for it with two alternatives, one as a part of MTHL, one as a separate alternative. The value-wise, you are not getting much difference between making an independent corridor and making it as a part of MTHL. Because the foundations which you partially say, the structure is same, different thing, everything is set on the same structure, the trains will run and the roads will run. And we submitted separate reports and those were accepted in principle, and when the first proposal was made by MMRDA, this was a part of it. Metro will be included. Then the question was metro will form part of the same alignment, separate alignment. And as the cost kept on adding and they wanted to go for PPP again, the PPP is the one which PPP that stage they said that if metro is included, this project cannot come on PPP. I said that whatever you may do, MTHL cannot come on PPP. Forget about metro or no metro. But I had a lone voice, therefore I was shunted out. And they say no metro. I said fine, it's your choice.
But even without PPP, it has.
So state metro. Government also said, take a metro, since it can be done independently and without being joined with it, cost is 15%, 20% different, we'll consider it as a separate project. That is how it got segmented. Because two alternatives are available. Cost, PPP was one consideration. Then an idea came that they can go on the same road, bridge. If not metro, they can put a more. Even that was examined. And after structurally we were told that monorail will not come free on this. You will have to put additional load, additional cost, additional structure of it. Everything will be required. So even that was dropped. Because the objective was somehow wo ek choti dabbi mein wo haathi ko fit karne ke liye peet peet ke usko kitna patla karoge dabbi mein sala hota ki poonch kabhi reh jati hai kabhi kaan bahar reh jata hai. उसी बेसिस के ऊपर में ए प्रोजेक्ट विच इज विजिबली नॉट जस्टिफाइड फॉर पीपीपी, इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू जस्टिफाई ऑन दैट बेसिस, इन द एंड दे ट्रिम्ड एवरीथिंग, और टांग भी काट दिया, वो भी काट दिया, करके बोला अच्छा ये प्रोजेक्ट रहेगा, इतनी कंसेशन भी जोड़ी उसमें, ये देंगे वो देंगे, नोबडी इवेंस कैन इंटरेस्ट इन दैट, बिकॉज इफ यू आर गोइंग टू डेवलप इट एज ए टोल बेस्ड ट्रांसपोर्ट प्रोजेक्ट, नो. Had you funded it as a development project, that by making this project, hectares after hectares of that south Mumbai, New Mumbai area will be developed, as was done for the Manpur link.
This
we started with PPP, dropped. With the full cash, dropped. Then PPP, dropped. Now is the fourth chance. JICA, the funds, I think that will be sensible.
But this metro is not being considered.
At the moment, not. It is not part of the project.
Because in the classic case,
but that
this is there could be no case like this thing in high.
railway gave this corridor in 1974 as an underground tunnel below the sea, as an 8th corridor to connect that area. That means 70s they had the wisdom. But today we have a different configuration.
There was a political champion to push the MTHL, and that was Mr. Anthuli. Unfortunately, it didn't last very long, and then there was no champion after that. And that's how it entire project is still dwindling.
It's not a project. One presentation was made to the state government that it should be developed as a development project, not as a transport toll based project. And the model was also presented. Mr. R.K. Jha, who you most of you know, he was the sort of author, and he came to RMMRDA, he discussed with us also, he had a talk with me. I said, yes, we should support it. And he made presentation to Mantralaya and all these things. But he found that nothing is happening, so he left Reliance and went to Gujarat. So he is now the MD of the Gibson.
On the lighter vein, Mukashi. Yeah. On the lighter vein, on the lightest vein, I want to say what PPP, and you said PPPPP. Actually, I call it PPPPP. What it means is pilferage of public property by private parties. If you look at it in the whole, I think that's what is tends to happen. The political ends, they look at that as an opportunity. How else can they start getting hundreds and hundreds of crores from nothing, almost?
That may be a bit of too much of exaggeration on the model. I beg to differ with you on that issue. That is right. But MTHL is one project which is badly needed.
And that is a great railway project.
I came to in contact with project in 1980-81. We have at Pune the officers training center for civil engineers. I was the, as you can say, one of the faculty members, and Mr. Menezes, who was retired as our chairman railway board, he came to Pune to discuss with the faculty members and others about this MTHL project. Then he said, reports have come, this has come. I still remember I asked him some question that was, because that was time we had a different view. Now being a part of LBG, I have a different view. So they, I asked a question that those reports, those foreign consultants have come and all that, they must be very good. But Mr. Menezes kept quiet for a minute and said, yes, Madan, they are printed on very nice paper. As he says rightly, Tata and all that, I have heard and read somewhere that Tatas were willing to construct that bridge if government only calls it Tata or their name. Even Ambanis were willing to finance that project because this would have given benefit to their SEZ. But they didn't want you any concern, just I'll provide and give it to you, that kind of thing. The question is not only of financing and all. The difficulty is, you see, the tender documents, which have been prepared by MSRDC and all that,
I had the opportunity of looking at those tender documents. The conditions which have been given, nobody in his senses will ever quote for that work. When that cash contract was invited second time, I knew at least 3 months in advance through my own sources, because I happened to know to those various parties, and they told me they are only wasting their time and our time, not one bid will be received.
Who is doing it? Why is...
And has it happened? Why? The documentation has got more corrections than the original document.
Deliberately it's been done.
I don't know. Using word deliberately is too much. I don't say anybody. Maybe sometime out of ignorance. You say the builder will have his own land for casting yard. Now you tell me along the MTHL, which builder or constructor, developer of that bridge can acquire land for doing this thing? Just tell me. Can he do it? He cannot do it.
Well, somebody who has land can build for it. Somebody who has a land will build it.
I don't know. I said, how it is possible? When we did small bridge like Thane Creek Bridge, we didn't ask him to bring the land for casting yard. We took the land, we developed that land, and we developed the casting depot there. And we so if you have this kind of unrealistic conditions, then you have to give me this boat, you have to give me one satellite. You got me 100 cars. Here also in MTH, they'll provide that condition. And luckily, our Mr. Sana was our commissioner at that time. I said, sir, MMRD has not reached that beggar's level where you beg from the contractors to give you telephones and to give you cars. Cannot you buy yourself? He said, where it is written, Madan? I said, this is written here, which they have not shown you. First thing he did, that entire thing he crossed, he says, no such conditions. If he gives you a car which costs you, let us say, 40,000 or 50,000 rupees or even 60,000 rupees a month, he will make another 60,000 on that. So, very strange. I sometimes wonder whether we are really interested in that project. 80, 70, I am doing 1981, and now we are in 2000. How many years have gone?
43.
Forget about old one. 2004 May, if I remember rightly, the tenders were invited on PPP mode by MSRDC. I was one of those who had the biggest shock of reading that advertisement in the paper. Abhi kuch to hai nahi hai, tender kis cheez ka invite kar rahe hain? Office mein se pucha, bole sahab rehne dijiye, koi iska jawab nahi hai. Abhi election aane wala hai agar September mein hi uske liye. अगर इस तरह से प्रोजेक्ट किए जाएंगे तो फिर प्रोजेक्ट्स किसी के विम्स के ऊपर नहीं होते. प्रोजेक्ट्स आर नीड बेस्ड, टाइम बेस्ड एंड पर्पस. दे आर नॉट सेटिस्फाइंग एनी इंडिविजुअल्स विम्स. अगर है ऐसा तो फिर जो हम लोग देख रहे हैं तमाशा है वो देखते रहेंगे, चलता रहेगा. बट वी आर नॉट विलिंग टू एक्सेप्ट दैट सिचुएशन. दैट इज व्हाई वी आर ऑल हियर.
The two questions, little technical, we have discussed in the finance.
This would be the last question.
Okay. It's a small one. Yeah. No, that's very small. One is regarding, I know, you had said 5 o'clock, so I remember that. One is about this gauge, that why standard gauge was chosen over broad gauge. Okay, because all our railways are broad gauge, but for metro, we have chosen standard gauge. So that is one question, that is there. And second is, we have gone for underground mainly because of the difficulties which we had for this present Metro 1, the disruption of the utilities, etc. This was one of the major, and also the complaints by the residents, that has been the difficulties which have been caused, the PAP, all such things. But underground, what I understand, that for the stations, you still have to go for cut and cover.
Not all stations, some stations.
So especially in the southern part of the city, where you already have so many buildings, how you are going to manage?
For stations. You will ask your second question first. Stations have got 7 different, out of 27 stations, there are 7 different typical designs for different stations. every station has it. Somewhere the tunnels go, both the tunnels go below the existing buildings. Somewhere one tunnel is below the buildings, another is below the road. Somewhere both tunnels are in the middle, both side of the road. Some villages you have place to access, go down. Some place you don't have even that place to access. Somewhere we have kept only minimum areas for the entire thing, cut and cover has been planned only beyond Bandra. This side, south side, they are either what is called as the mining or tunneling method. The intention there is that you drill the tunnel through and then you make an access shaft, and through that shaft you widen the tunnel to create the platforms by drilling and blasting and this. And where even that is not possible, so access, then you go into the side, then come side, and then create. For example, Kalabadevi station. Earlier we thought of having two small boxes only to enter. But when we started examining it further, we found even that is not possible because just space is not available. Even that space perhaps somehow we would have squeezed in because many minimum distance we could have adjusted. There is no space above vertically to use the pile rigs or to use the diaphragm rigs. So now that entire station design has been changed into fully mining station. So you will only have a small hole on the side from where you access and create the entire station underground like mines, mining. So you have only entry access to the side. So there are about seven different typical designs where one, as I say, one tunnel is there below, one is outside, two below. Kalabadevi, for example, both the tunnels go below the buildings and you have only entry exit from the side.
What
will
happen? You didn't think of acquiring a building?
Not at the moment, but we have got every single building surveyed in detail. We know which are vulnerable buildings, which need pre-strengthening, which will not need pre-strengthening. And question of gauge. The major reason for gauge is that internationally, I should say a majority of the railway systems follow standard gauge. Intention was that if we go for broad gauge, you will not get certain things. Structure, there is no problem, I make it locally. It is basically the rolling stock. Rolling stock, if you want to go for international bidding, for example, Delhi Metro started, their half their fight was on standard gauge and broad gauge. But then they said, width has been kept as 3.2 meter of the broad gauge, and they adopted broad gauge. Calcutta Metro has got broad gauge, but a meter gauge train. So it is not finally people who travel on the rails, they travel in the coach. Here, even if it is a standard gauge, the coach width is 3.2 meter only. 3.66 meter on standard gauge, it is not is not dynamically stable. Market was tested for 3.66 meter coaches, whether anybody is willing to give that. MRVC, the rakes they wanted for Suburban, they said we want stainless steel rakes and other things. We want 3.66 meter coach. Only one bid came. Because they have to develop the entire thing fresh. So they said, we'll do it for you, but we'll charge you three times your estimated cost. So World Bank said, hell with you, this, we are not going to pay you this kind of money. So then MRVC has to change their thing. The tenders were broken into two parts, ICF, our Madras, our, you know, their Perambur, their, which is already proven and tested running. Firstly, it may be cheaper, and I may not have to reinvent the wheel, which has been proved right, because the moment you have got a standard gauge, this thing, people have come from outside and set up factories here in your country to supply you rolling stock right here. Bombardier has supplied more than 400 coaches to Delhi Metro. The rates have come down. Alstom has set up a factory for Chennai. Now, these factories will give you stock for other places also, because this is, has got a market elsewhere. The moment you ask for broad gauge, Pakistan Railway, Bangla Railway, Indian Railway only, nowhere else. So nobody is interested in manufacturing and developing that thing for you, they have a very small, they want a global this thing, you see. So I think on the whole capacity, we have lost nothing. 3.66 meter, we were totally dead against it. We never wanted, because in the turnings also, curvatures and all that was a serious problem. So we said that if you keep the standard gauge and coach width as 3.2 meter, it is fine. But the blunder has been done by Delhi Metro. They have got two gauges. They have got standard gauge with 2.9 meter coach. They have got broad gauge with 3.2 meter coach. And now they have got standard gauge with 3.2 meter coach. So one side, Indian Railway is going for unified gauge. And Delhi Metro has got two gauges. Obviously, it has to be different lines. I think I don't want to go into the reasons for that portion. The reason was simple, that they said now since this is cheaper, available and all that, why not go for it? Earlier, coaches came from Rotem, Hyundai, along with your BML Bangalore. They developed the coaches. Later on, next lot came by Bombardier. Here, our line one, the order was so small, Bombardier said, we are not interested in 50, 60 coaches. And between the French company and between the Chinese company, the tender cost difference was 100 crores. So it's not a small amount. So when it was seen that the Chinese are bitten up properly so that they fit with our specifications, a lot of hard work has gone in getting the coaches through them to ensure that the quality of the work is, a lot of work has gone into that. But finally you have got a cheaper version, a cheaper market opened for you. 100 crore was difference for how many coaches? 64 coaches. That means roughly 2 crore rupees extra per coach. This is where is a financing. Marketing is a, gauge is not a simple issue which you can simply take on emotions. We have got a lot of brickbats in MMRDA from a lot of experts, and on this issue there was a huge fight. One of my senior officer who is no longer alive today, one day said, "Tum udhar mein ho, tab bhi meri baat nahi mante." Maine kaha, "Aap hamare kabhi aate kyun nahi? Hamara koi aapse jhagda hai kya?" Bole, "Nahi, hum aapse standard gate, broad gate ka jhagda kar rahe hain, to tumhare office mein kaise aayenge?" Maine kaha, "Wo jhagda baar ki cheez hai, tum mere senior the, aaj bhi senior ho, aaoge main aaj bhi aapko chai coffee pilaunga." To wo thoda sa embarrassed hue. Baad mein unhone kaha ki, "Nahi, theek hai, abhi chalo, ho gaya, decision nahi hai." Lekin mera personal honest opinion ye hai, it was not a wrong decision. Our Chennai has been able to produce all these coaches for our MRVC because the amount of inputs which have been given, but they refused to produce stainless steel coaches. First lot, they said, "We don't have the technology of welding." The second lot, now they have produced stainless steel because they brought welding units different, the system technology testing. World Bank said, "No, for next lot you do it, we'll give you training, we'll give you this thing." So the new rakes which will come, I think they will be always stainless steel. Because for Mumbai, stainless steel is certainly a better version. You don't need painting, you don't need, corrosion problems are avoided. Otherwise, corrosion maintenance of these existing rakes is one of the biggest money consumer, you see. That. NG? Aluminium does not give you any different advantage, it has disadvantages. Cost-wise and weight-wise, is not. But one tender option was given that you can use aluminium or steel, but people still prefer steel. Elstom and all that, they are using aluminium. Firstly, aluminium they are painting. We are not painting. If you leave it blank, it will get oxidized after some time. Then weight-wise, you don't get much. Plus vibrations and all that, it causes problems. So there are more negatives for, and cost-wise and weight-wise, if I don't gain, but not that they are, the aluminium is being used several places.
What question
do you do? Don't worry. She is worried more about me than. What time normally you close your office?
No, the
5 karte to ghar mein 10 baje kar do actually when this is gag we created yoga so that we can
so the question that why we are so likely to be air conditioned buses both for the regular lines as well as metro because they are all air conditioned but are we the harbor or regular system why can't we have these AC buses are they so expensive air produced and deep run or are they the other problem
yes first question is yes your answer is yes to the first question they are expensive and they are expensive to run also there's no doubt about it the second problem is that you will not be able to have this kind of loading on that trains but the proposal has been given by Central Railway way back Western Railway way back to bring in rakes then they said this train will carry 1000 people present train is carrying 4000 people that means one line path you have taken so you have reduced the sectional capacity by 3000 major problem first cost is the problem no doubt about it then you will have to charge more people more fare so if you are willing to pay people don't want to pay their 100 rupees from Thane to Mumbai for 50 journeys yes there is a section of people that is why I raised the issue of affordability of whom there are people here who are willing to pay for air conditioned services and maybe that is why the elevated corridor was planned for fully air conditioned services they said we cannot introduce in the existing rake because ek train aayega air conditioned hai dusra nahi hai itna hi hai to agar karna hai to pura ac separate kar do which is a future
Good technology for bus. We are considering the largest car manufacturer in the world, in process, in the short term. So why we have not at all developed the manufacturing rate for bus? And we are pretty both quantity and quality.
We have ICF.
And now Bareilly, another coach factory is coming. Indian Railways requirements, these factories are more than enough to accommodate. But for manufacturing a metro coach,
you see, the manufacturer of the variant is not only with the railway, and they are so stubborn. Even the entire these rakesh, sorry, smashing railway.
You know what, rakesh was the board when it came, and all general managers were invited to railway board that he wanted to make a presentation. So he said that all our reports have been, you know, filed, no action has been taken, so we have to come with Indian Railway, very heavily studied organization, etc., etc. So my colleague was sitting by my side as Mr. Rakesh Bhor is a very optimistic person. He says, why? He thinks that his report will not meet the same fate with other reports.
He touched the
wrong place. If you want to restructure the railway board, they will never agree. Had he said you structure central railway, he will agree. This little Rakesh Mohan was privatized, corporatization, separation. Oh, why union something? That will not happen. But manufacturing capacity so far, railway is no requirement concerned. We are not importing anything. We are not having
our modernization is quite slow. That for example, our Dubai suburban system, how long the rake? Or they said now I see some wrong breaks being made in the high difference around.
Yes. Railway ne bahut pehle in 1670s they decided that we are not going to invest in some. This is basically finance. Not that modernization coaches, not today, I have got money, I can do it. Fundamentally they decided that no, this is not my priority area. My priority area is not.
Technology,
railway is right that railway there is no right or wrong, it is only my way. service, but not that the railway is incapable of doing that. These factories are already producing. They are used to even export the goods.
I mean, they are all imported goods for all the southern things.
All coaches have been manufactured by ICF. Bombardier has provided the sole. The electricals we are not manufacturing. Electricals have now Bombardier and Siemens are manufacturing the electricals here in the country. But some of the components are there which they get from Germany and elsewhere. It's only electricals. The rest of the entire coach, bogies are nothing here in Chennai. It is only the electricals, because this is a 25 kV AC system, plus with regenerative braking and three-phase AC traction, all over decks are already AC traction. In this technology, we are not having at the moment within the railway. So we have to go forward. Otherwise, the coach is about 2.5 crores. Half crore is hardly one-third cost of electricals. That is, आपके भी सारी कोचेज मेट्रो कोचेज बन रही है ना बड़ौदा में जाइए आप देखिए मार्टिन की फैक्ट्री दे आर इन्वेस्टेड मनी यू वांट टू इन्वेस्ट मनी एंड मेक कोचेज एल्सो में सेट अप फैक्ट्री नाउ सीमेंस वाज कंसीडरिंग टू सेट अप फैक्ट्री बट दे डोंट हैव मार्केट आपके तो Tomorrow, if they don't get orders from Baroda, they will close and go to Canada. Market work like this.
We should be the biggest market for
I repeat that Indian Railways have no shortage of coaches, they have plenty of manufacturing capacity. But for metro, they are not considered that they are subject. This point was raised before the Planning Commission. Your Sardarji Ahluwalia was present, five ministers were present. I happened to be present in that meeting. Railway said, we should go for broad gauge because you can manufacture coaches here. Ahluwalia said, first look out for your house before you mess somebody else. Mare ko apna to kaam pura nahi hota, dusre ka kaam karo. He was off, just shut up. Even at the highest level, planning commissions are clear that jitna railway chal rahi hai, dheere dheere, let private investment come in and manufacture same coaches here. Why do you want to get it? That has happened. Two factories have come up which have capacity of supplying you coaches like 500, 600 coaches they have supplied to Delhi Metro. Apart from Baroda and Chennai with Alstom is the French company, they supply now to Chennai. Like this, I am sure if they get more orders. Plus, this becomes your app from here.
You mean that we should be adding more orders?
More orders means
we are making 6 million cars. I can't understand it.
More orders of SRL, sir. अभी मान लिया आप यहाँ पर 100 किलोमीटर मेट्रो क्रिएट कर रहे हैं तो 100 किलोमीटर मेट्रो के लिए हमको कम से कम 500 से 600 कोचेज लगेंगे ये मार्केट है अब ये मार्केट कहाँ से सप्लाई होगा ये बम्बार्डियर अगर कंट्री में है इसने ऑलरेडी दिल्ली की कोई स्टैंडर्डाइज की हुई है वो सप्लाई करेगा कॉस्ट हमारे लिए 75% हो
जाएगा
Bombardier was not prepared to take a small order. They said if we have a big order, they had 400 plus coaches order from Delhi, immediately they said,
okay. They are not standard coaches.
Coach is standard. Is a question of 2.9 meter, 2.8 meter. Is it demand? If you want it more specific. 3.2 standard is the biggest. And the smaller is 4.89. And in Hyderabad will have. Delhi has got 2.9. So there are you can have narrower standard deal you can't have. Wider than that. Ministry of Urban Development has already taken lead. And standardization for metro is one of the subjects. tell me what should I do. In the morning we have that session and see the, how best we can go for the second.
So it's another 2 years before the operation.
At the moment they are contemplating to finish the operation. But let's see, there are two critical locations.
And this Vada should be
which they are trying to. They are perhaps interfaces with railway also. Now some sanctions are put on the this will take it. Otherwise, most of the problems have been sorted out. I think just one or two areas are there which are now going to put some constraints. Let's see. Let's see all possible. We read your articles.
Thank you. But you know, there was some other event today for 100 years of Mahatma Gandhi's return.
So, yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
You have some more questions?
Sure, sure.
So, no question.
I'm Madan, sir.